A while ago, I picked up my own Azeron, a programmable keypad, and I've been using it comfortably with the PC to play some games instead of using the keyboard and controller like I usually do. It has a very nice analog stick, and the keys are all programmable with so many that I can put on there that I have more than I need. While it is expected that you use the mouse in the right hand when you play PC games with the Azeron, you're gonna see lots of videos of people doing the exact same thing, so I'm gonna try something different. Instead of the mouse, I'm gonna use a right Joy-Con for Nintendo Switch. Well, why the Joy-Con? Well, it's one half of a controller, it fits perfectly within my right hand, I have all the buttons that I need and another analog stick that I need to, and it has a gyroscope that I can use to aim just about as good as a mouse. Let me show you how I do this. The software I use as of the time of this video is reWASD 5.8.1. It has Azeron support and Nintendo Switch Joy-Con support. The important thing is that with reWASD, you're able to combine the two of them into one single controller. I'm going to show you how to do that. First, I plug in the Azeron via the USB cable. Actually, before you do that, make sure you close Steam or any other remapping program you may have your computer that's running. Just make sure it doesn't interfere. The Azeron will appear down in the left side here with this little icon. If you click on it, it'll warn you that reWASD will work with Azeron exclusive mode. This just means that you can't use the official Azeron software to change the bindings. You have to do everything within reWASD while you have the mappings enabled. Just click agree. Then I'm going to connect my Nintendo Switch Joy-Con controller. I'm going to connect that with Bluetooth. When the Joy-Con's connected, it'll also appear on the bottom left right here, have a little Joy-Con icon. If you click on it, it'll rumble. That's how you know that reWASD is working with the Joy-Con. So let's go back to the Azeron. And right next to the Azeron's name, there's gonna be a little plus icon with a weird quadrilateral and it says group with other devices. Click on this, and then you'll see this grouping menu right here. On the left is gonna be the Azeron. The second menu right here, you're gonna switch to Nintendo Switch Joy-Con R. Then click the save icon on the right. We now have the Azeron paired with the Nintendo Switch Joy-Con. Now, I already have a profile set up within reWASD. I'll probably put a link in the description. What I do is that for the game that I choose on the right side menu is DS4 on Steam. This means that I convert the Azeron and the Joy-Con into a DualShock 4 controller. A fully functional one with gyroscope, analog sticks, and triggers and buttons and everything. So I go click on this, DS4 on Steam. And this will show me the bindings within the Azeron and the Joy-Con linked together. You're free to use my profile, but if you want to change any of the bindings, it's as easy as clicking on the button that you see in the diagram and switching to the controller button that you want mapped. If you're going to do this yourself, what I would like to make sure that you do is that when you go up here onto this top right menu, if you have this icon enabled like so, where you have the open eye, make sure that you click on here to add new subconfig and click on gamepad one time just so that you have gamepad and gamepad 2 here. This is because you need to have two gamepads within this binding to switch between the two devices. The Azeron is going to be on the first gamepad because that's the left controller we mapped in the grouping, and the Joy-Con will be under gamepad 2. We click on this, it'll switch the interface to the right Joy-Con. And we can leave this alone, but the important thing is that down here, you click onto this gyroscope icon, and then you turn on gyro. So that way, your gyro mappings will be mapped from a Joy-Con to a DS4 controller. Once that's all done, click on apply, and then you should see in the bottom left corner, they'll see remap is on. This means that we now have combined the Azeron and the Joy-Con controller into a single controller, plugged into slot 1. Now that we have the mapping done, let's go right into Steam. And now, any game you pick, as long as there's a control support, you can now use this with your Azeron Joy-Con controller. It'll follow any DualShock 4 bindings you already have. On the bottom right here, you can see this overlay. This shows the output of reWASD's DualShock 4. But I'm controlling this with the Azeron. And the right side, the right stick, and the face buttons, I'm controlling with the Joy-Con. The little gyro meter on here, that's popping back and forth. That is the gyro meeting that's going back and forth. I didn't change anything with the reWASD software to make the gyro work like this. All it's doing is that it's adapting the Joy-Con gyro to the DualShock 4 controller. So any DualShock bindings that I have made in Steam will work perfectly fine. My reWASD configuration prevents any issues of mouse and gamepad bindings being mixed together in the game. And with practice, you can stand out about as well as any other keyboard and mouse user. And if you like seeing someone try attempting bullets per minute from time to time, trying to beat the game on the hard difficulties, I'm trying to do as much as I can with the Azeron and Joy-Con combos, or with DualShock controllers with the gyro. So subscribe to my channel and look at my playlist and see my latest attempts.